So, Mike, the Blackhawks, they'll go home game six, down 3-2. But Jonathan Toews, a guy who missed 22 straight games with a concussion, how clutch is this guy?
Obviously, he's the guy that they look to. I mean, they've been banged around a little bit, the Hawks. He comes back in game one, gets them jump-started with the first goal of the series. He's got the last goal of the series, a huge goal. It looked like the Chicago was on their way to the showers late in this game. It was total control by Phoenix, but thanks to Toews, they go home with a chance to live another day.
Let's bring things back east and get back to Pittsburgh and Philadelphia. The Flyers lead the series 3-2. Short time ago, the Pens' James Neal spoke with our Brian Engblom.
James, it's been a strange series. You guys got down 3-0 early on. What did you change in your approach to come back and win the last two?
Well, we knew we had the confidence in the room, and we knew we had the character guys. We just needed to start playing like it, and, you know, it started here.
Are you all the way back to your A game?
I hope so. I mean, our backs are the wall, and I think we have to be, so it'll be a good one tonight.
Are you expecting a high-scoring game?
I don't know. Who knows what could happen in this series?
Thanks, James.
Thanks.
James Neal talking about his team getting back to their A game. One guy who seemingly has done that is Marc-Andre Fleury. It's almost like we've forgotten that this guy is an elite goaltender in this league.
Well, with all the craziness in the first part of this series, it was easy to lose sight of the fact that this is an elite-level guy who's won a Stanley Cup championship. In fact, stood firm right at the end of that win against the Detroit Red Wings. But watch the saves here on Danny Briere in the third period. Absolutely heroic. 7 shots on one particular power play for the Philadelphia Flyers, and Marc-Andre Fleury had them all. He was really good. He was athletic, but he was in control. Watch the rebound gobble up right there. Nobody's going to get second cracks at it. Their defense was better in front of Marc-Andre Fleury, but make no mistake, his athleticism, his reads as a goaltender was what won this game for the Pittsburgh Penguins and sent it back to Philadelphia.
Marc-Andre Fleury has found his game. Ilya Bryzgov still looking for the piece in his soul, a 4.55 goals against average in this series. They give him a $51 million contract. He says he's afraid of Bears if he loses this series, and it's this ugly. Is he going to be afraid of the Philadelphia media?
He will be, and it's a big moment. I thought he handled the last game fairly well. There was nothing really he could point a finger at that was awful, although in game four, it was just awful. His lateral mobility seemed to be checked somewhat. Watch these two goals, same spots. Letang gets that one. Not very good, so questions about would he even start in game five. He did. He wasn't facing a barrage of Pittsburgh shots, but he did his job pretty solidly. Can't fault him in any way, and hopefully going back home, he'll have a chance to get this thing closed out. But remember, this is a place, Philadelphia, which is not kind to goaltenders and wasn't kind to Bryzgalov early in the season. He found peace in his soul, as you put it, for a little while. Let's see if he can find it today.
We'll see if Mr. Universe can bounce back. One very strange trend in this series, the team that has scored the first goal has lost all 5 games of the series. Puck drop for the Pens and Flyers is coming up soon. Evgeny Malkin led the NHL in scoring during the regular season. He's got 2 goals and 5 assists in the postseason. Back to Philly right after these messages.
This has been the ADT MVC Sports Update. ADT Security Services, the world leader in home and business security.
Keep up with every NHL playoff story at ProHockeyTalk.com on NBCSports.com and follow the exciting NHL on NBC Sports action on Facebook.
Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, city of brotherly love, but there's no love lost when this city's Flyers play host to their cross-state rivals from Pittsburgh.
The Flyers win game one in overtime. Couturier, the hat trick for the Flyers!
On the brink of having their Stanley Cup hopes come to an abrupt end, the NHL's pre-playoff favorite had to respond. Now the Penguins and Flyers first-round showdown is officially on. That after a 10-goal message was delivered to stave off elimination on enemy ice.
They go to Kennedy, a slapper, shoots, a score! Kennedy with a big booming slap shot.
Then a statement was made in Game 5, this time by their much-beleaguered goaltender, who restored order to his crease in a frantic third period.
And the Flyers shake their heads for the first time in this series.
Momentum has shifted. Game 6 is next. It's the Stanley Cup playoff presented by GEICO. Game 6 of the Eastern Conference quarterfinals. The Philadelphia Flyers up 3-2 can wrap it up on home ice against their arch rivals, the Pittsburgh Penguins. What an atmosphere we expect here at Wells Fargo Center. Good afternoon. Thanks for joining us. I'm Dave Strader. It was 3 weeks ago today here on NBC in Pittsburgh. Flyers and Penguins met in a regular season game. Emotions boiled over. Remember, the coaches got involved, and we all wondered, what would a first-round matchup look like? Well, this first-round matchup has not disappointed. Team scoring first, 0-5. Lead changes every game. Emotions plenty. And goals, how about 50 of them? Let's bring in our man inside the glass, my partner, Brian Engblom. With 50 goals in 5 games, I'm sure people on both sides are saying, Brian, time for a goaltender to step up and steal a game.
Yeah, that's true. I think Marc-Andre Fleury has already done that. In the first 3 games of the series, he just didn't look like the usual Marc-Andre Fleury. 17 goals against. But in Game 5, he was brilliant, especially the last 5 or 6 minutes of the game. There was a power play by the Philadelphia Flyers. They were storming the Penguins, and especially Danny Briere, with two just outstanding chances. In the dying minutes there, Marc-Andre Fleury came up big the way he has for them all season long. The Pittsburgh Penguins definitely need him to be at the same level again here in this Game 6 to survive.
For just the second time in the careers of Crosby and Malkin, when they're both in the lineup in a playoff game and fail to score, the Penguins still won Game 5. They have other guys that can bring it.
Well, Jordan Staal has been known as the best number 3 center in the National Hockey League, but guess who's leading the Pittsburgh Penguins in scoring so far in the series? Jordan Staal. He's got 9 points. Only one of them is on the power play. One of the biggest differences when he's getting his scoring chances, he's pulling the trigger. He's just not looking to pass. Here was a good example. The 2-on-1, he didn't look to pass the puck. He filled the top shelf, and that made all the difference in that game.
Pittsburgh does have scoring depth down the middle, but when you look at the top two centers for Philadelphia, Brian, they can bring it as well.
Oh, there's no doubt. Claude Giroux is one of the most talented players in the entire league, and he leads everybody in the playoffs with 11 points. He's got 4 points on the power play, and he's also got 3 shorthanded, which shows you he plays in all situations, and he just seems to know exactly what to do all the time, where to be, when to pass, and when to pull the trigger. Danny Briere is one of those sneaky sharpshooters. When he gets a chance, he usually doesn't need a second chance. He hides in the weeds a lot. You don't know where he is. And then all of a sudden, he shows up with the puck on his stick. Danny Briere needs to play at that high level again to hear if Philly's going to close this out.
This is the 6th all-time playoff meeting between these cross-state rivals from Philadelphia and Pittsburgh. And this one might be the most unpredictable.
That's going to do it. Underdogs in the first round, says who? One of the wildest series ever takes a dangerous turn now.
The Stanley Cup playoffs on NBC are brought to you by the 2012 Ford F-150, built for tough. By Bud Light, the sure sign of a good time. Here we go. By Verizon, 4G LTE, America's fastest 4G network. And by McDonald's, I'm loving it. And welcome back inside Wells Fargo Center prior to Game 6. Let's get on ice level. Brian Engblom with the Flyers, Kimmo Tiiminen.
Kimmo, it's been a wild series here. It was a runaway, now it's not. What's important in this afternoon's game?
Well, it's our home building, our fans behind us, so we got to play our game. We got to attack these guys and make sure we put the puck behind their knee and go forecheck.
Do you win this one on special teams?
Well, both teams are really good power play, so obviously we have to stay out of the box, and you know, but overall, we got to play our game.
Thank you.
Thanks, Mark.
Well, it's only a hockey game, but when it's Flyers-Penguins, it just feels like so much more.
Look out, look out is right.
To the Stanley Cup playoffs presented by Geico. Game 6 of the Eastern Conference quarterfinal series. The Philadelphia Flyers leading the Pittsburgh Penguins 3-2. And it has been a strange series. When you look at these numbers for these goaltenders, a save percentage of under 84% for Marc-Andre Fleury and just over 84% for Ilya Bryzgalov. But as Brian Engblom pointed out at the top of the show, Fleury, especially in the third period of game 5, which, by the way, is the only scoreless period we've had in this series, he was outstanding in helping to extend this series to a game 6 here this afternoon. Dave Strader up in the broadcast booth. Brian Engblom is our man between benches inside the glass. Crosby and Giroux, who actually fought each other in the Wild Game 3 here in this building, start things off as the puck is deflected near the Pittsburgh bench, and Crosby is knocked to the ice with a hard hit as Dupuis back the other way. That puck is in the glove of Ilya Bryzgalov.
That's the way to start the game. Claude Giroux up against Sidney Crosby, and you want to get the fans going in your own building? Hit Crosby. That's a good, clean, solid hit. Crosby just knocking the puck ahead, and Giroux just plain finished his check. Boy, that's the way to set the stage here. Perfect.
Crosby, terrific in the faceoff circle in the last game, wins this one, but it's cleared up the far side. Jaromir Jagr had it knocked off his stick. He recovers and plays it out to center ice. Letang tried to hammer it back in deep. It didn't get very far. And now Jagr trying to play it ahead, but it's knocked away. Picked up here, though, by Giroux. Shot scored! Giroux just 32 seconds in.
What more can you say about this? Claude Giroux with the big hit against Sidney Crosby, and then he has a set of hands that are incredible. He makes a little bit of a move. Nobody moves on him. He creates his own time and space, cuts back into the middle. The right-hand shot on the left-hand side. His stick gets a great angle to the net. He just picks his target, no pressure on him at all, and he fills the top shelf.
Well, we just sang the praises of Marc-Andre Fleury and how he finished game five. That's a great shot, but how will that impact the confidence of the Pittsburgh goaltender who was beaten just 32 seconds in? Sixth goal of this series for Claude Giroux, who had a six-point game, including a hat-trick in game two of this series.
But Dave, I think that shot goes in against any goaltender in the National Hockey League. He just ripped that one right up under the bar. So I'm not sure the confidence level wise certainly won't help him, but I don't think it's going to destroy him either. Where was everybody on Pittsburgh? Nobody did anything to Giroux.
Here's Couturier now across the line. He dumps it back in deep. Eric Wellwood in on the forecheck, as is Voracek with a big hit on England, and that gets the crowd excited here at Wells Fargo Center as Matt Cook now for the Penguins. Sends it back in deep. Ilya tried to get a stick on it. He gets some help now. Kubina plays it up the wall, but it's blocked by Stahl. Recovered here by Breer. Plays it hard around on the far side. Voracek, the overtime hero of game one, as it's broken up center ice. And dumped back in behind Ilya Bryzgalov, who has been staked to a 1-0 lead here in the early going. Intercepted high slot. Kennedy's shot is knocked down in front. And the puck rolls to the near boards. Now it comes to Kennedy. Kennedy waits. The late penalty coming as Fleury gets to the bench. A shot here, deflected. And Bryzgalov got a piece of it. Good pressure by the Penguins. Now a hit by Braden Schenn. And we're going to get the first power play of this game six.
It's going to be a high sticking penalty. It looks like Danny Briere, he's trying to plead his case. That's happened just inside the blue line. The stick comes up and it's inadvertent. He hits Brian straight up in the face and shoulder area there, even though it wasn't intentional. He did get the stick up. So a chance here for Pittsburgh to get some momentum back.
So Briere to the box. And the Penguins get the power play opportunity. They have been pretty good in this series at 8 for 24. That's 33%. I would have said great, except that it's the Philadelphia power play that's been the story, converting better than 50% of their opportunities. Giroux, what a move he made to sidestep the attempt to check there by Kunitz. As Fleury now tries to stick this puck up the board, but it's recovered now by Evgeny Malkin.
The great players have radar. That was Giroux with radar to sidestep Kunitz.
Talbot able to check Malkin, but now Crosby slides it across. Here is Kunitz. Sends it to Malkin for a one-timer. The save by Bryzgalov. Back to the line now, Letang. Backhands it along. Malkin, seeing eye pass to the far side. Sullivan tees it up for a shot pass. Knocked down by Bryzgalov. Loose puck. Still no whistle. Now we get a whistle from Kelly Sutherland, who's one of the referees along with Kevin Pollock this afternoon. Expand your hockey experience with the Verizon StarCam on NBCSports.com and NHL.com. Throughout the game, we're streaming a live ISOCam following star players like Sidney Crosby and Claude Giroux, who you see there. The Verizon Star Cam is available now at NBCSports.com and NHL.com.
Bo Giroux has got radar. He just senses somebody is coming at him, gets his head up. Not only does he sidestep it, but he keeps the puck. I think he has sonar too, but sonar won't work in this building. It's too loud. And then in the last sequence here, Pittsburgh Penguins going to the net really hard, never giving up on the puck.
Back to the line now. It comes to Letang with a drive. That was blocked by Tiemannin. Cleared to the line, but not out. Sullivan slides it across. Now here is Malkin. And Tiemannin without a stick. Far side, it comes to Malkin. Malkin takes a look to the front. Quickly drops it back, Sullivan. Straight away for Letang. Hands it off to Crosby. Crosby, high slot. Now it comes to Letang. Crosby again on the near side. Crosby patient with it. Sends it far side, Sullivan. Now to Malkin.
The other side's the intelligent side to work because there's no stick.
Now Malkin. Trying to break down this penalty-killing box of the Philadelphia Flyers. It comes high slot again, and it's set wide and cleared by Couturier.
That was really smart by Couturier. Malkin moved over on the same side as Crosby because Matt Reed didn't have a stick. He had to give it to Tiemannin. So you always try to work the guy without the stick. Couturier crossed over with Malkin and switched sides with Reed.
Letang coming late. Little foot pass to Niskanen. Niskanen shot. That may have hit the goalpost. Now Niskanen slides it across. Here's Letang again for Jordan Staal. Slides it across. Out of the box comes Briere. Now a centering pass is blocked. Teams at full strength. Pittsburgh still putting on pressure. Angled off the boards. Letang able to swipe that and hold it in momentarily. Now it comes outside the zone.
Boy, that was some terrific penalty killing. Lots of puck possession for Pittsburgh, and they show you a lot of different looks. But Philadelphia was all over all of those different looks.
Lead pass for Kennedy out of his reach. Going to be icing here against Pittsburgh on the touch-up by Braden Coburn. Let's take a look now at our Coors Light cold, hard facts. And it has been a strange series. 0-5, the team scoring first, just the third time in NHL history. First five games of the series. 17th team, the Penguins, to lose the first three games and then win the next two. And now 51 goals combined with only one scoreless period as this shot, with Fleury dealing with plenty of traffic, was steered aside. And it's cleared back the other way.
And these two teams always come to play early. They have 51 goals in the series now, 24 in the first period.
Yeah, just incredible starts by both teams offensively. Now it's played ahead and recovered by Van Riemsdyk, playing in just his second game. He missed quite a bit of time during the regular season because a couple of injuries. He missed time with a concussion and then blocked a shot and broke a bone in his foot. Back on March the 1st and did not play until Game 5 the other night in Pittsburgh. So Van Riemsdyk coming back. Ooh, Vitali, dangerous, got tied up there with a Philadelphia player. They both went down. That was Gustafson, the young defenseman, as it's backhanded center ice. And Jágr flips it high in the air, gloved down by Dubinek Mikulajczyk. And cleared back out through center ice. This is so different, Brian, than the series we just came from, the 4-5 matchup in the Western Conference, where the team scoring first won every game, and there wasn't a single lead change between Nashville and Detroit. As Carl tried to get one through, that was knocked down by Vitali. Back to the line, a shot is hammered here, but it's picked off and recovered by Englund, who wraps it around, and it's tipped out through center ice. Aldilia plays it around for the Flyers, overstepping it was Giroux. Crosby tried to quickly send it across for Malkin, but it's picked off. And Giroux hands it off now to Voracek. Voracek, top of the circle, waits. And he sent it well wide of the Pittsburgh goal. His team in it steps up and holds it in.
Well, the pace and the tempo was terrific here, and the home fans putting a lot of the pressure on the referees. Every time a Flyer gets touched, they're going to put pressure on them to make it out. Home ice advantage.
Now Fleury. Letang quickly to Derek Englund. Penguins again this afternoon going with 11 forwards and 7 defensemen. Eric Tangrady is out of the lineup and Vitali is in as one of the two extra forwards on that fourth line as a centering attempt by Malkin was blocked.
Terrific play by Gustafson there to go down and take away that pass. Kunitz was going to the front of the net.
Now here is Niskanen for the Penguins in deep for Malkin. Protecting the puck. Angles it off the boards now. Dupre on the far side, a one-timer. Prescott able to knock that aside. Here is Kunitz now. Malkin again. Malkin tried to put it in front. Kunitz scoots out from behind the net now. Sends it out to the far point. Niskanen, Simone Dupre with a shot that was steered aside by Colbert, held in at the line by the Penguins. Wellwood gets to it and able to clear it out to center ice.
A lot of pressure there by Pittsburgh, and just a careless pass by Niskanen takes away all that pressure that they had. Especially the last couple of games, the Pittsburgh Penguins have outplayed the Philadelphia Flyers 5-on-5, and you saw a sample of it there just by the sheer puck possession inside the zone.
Pittsburgh with 15 5-on-5 goals in this series, the Flyers with 9 out of their 25. They have done it on the power play and also shorthanded.
Yeah, the Flyers haven't scored an even strength goal in the last two games.
Until the one scored by Claude Giroux here early this afternoon, they had not scored an even strength goal since the third period of game number 4. Let's go inside the glass, presented by Progressive Insurance with Brian Engblom.
Well, you always want your best players to be your best players, but having a great start is also an important thing as well, too. Well, you take Claude Giroux and say, I'm going to set the tone here. Right off the bat, he gets the big hit on Sidney Crosby, gets the fans into it, gets his team into it, and then look at this move into the middle of the ice and then pulls the trigger. You can plan to be good early. You don't know that you're going to get a shot at Sidney Crosby early, of course, but when you see it and take advantage and then score the goal, can't be any better than that.
Yeah, it was actually early third period, game 3, Brian, the last time that the Flyers had scored even strength in this series until that goal by Giroux just 32 seconds in. As Hartnell now lays it in deep behind Fleury. He settles it down. Hartnell comes in. He puts a big hit on McCulloch and knocks him down. As Vitali starts it back the other way. Good hard work on the back check there by Jagr. Broke that up. And now we get a whistle as Carl and Letang have to be separated. There's another gathering further down the boards. Claude Giroux has been the most dangerous player in this series, and he proves why just 32 seconds into game 6, 1-0 Philadelphia.
Strong forecheck by the Philadelphia Flyers in the last shift. It was Scotty Hartnell coming in. He gets a bead on Zibanejad McCulloch. That's an intelligent hit. It's a forceful hit, but he comes in and sort of swoops around and hits him along the same line as the boards. He didn't run him from behind, didn't run him directly into the boards. That's a good, safe, hard hit by Scotty Hartnell.
Take a look at his numbers in the series. 24 hits is the one that tells the real story. Flyers have one shot on goal, but it was Giroux that connected, and they have the 1-0 lead here in this game 6, trying to close out this series. Pittsburgh looking to extend it to a game 7, which would be on Tuesday night back at Consol Energy Center. And as Fleury leaves it now as Letang wraps it around. Cook could not control. Lilia backhands it ahead, and the Flyers back into their own zone to regroup here.
Something both teams have used pretty well throughout this series is stretch passes. They'll go from deep inside their own zone all the way to the far blue line if it's open.
Now Voracek trying to get in. Letang tying him up. Voracek gets to it. Sends it back to the line. Shot by Lilia, and it got all the way through to Marc-Andre Fleury, and he covers up. Let's take a look at the remainder of the NHL schedule coming up the next couple of days. Of course, immediately following us here on NBC, it'll be game 6 of Boston and Washington. Later tonight, game 5 between the Kings and the Canucks. And then tomorrow, Rangers and Senators in Ottawa, with the Senators having a chance to wrap up that series. And the Coyotes and Blackhawks on CNBC. Game 6, the first 5 games of that series have gone to overtime.
Well, another big hit there in this game early on. That's Brooks Orpik coming in and finishing off Danny Briere. Briere was trying to make the play at the blue line. He did. He got bent over backwards a little bit right in front of the Pittsburgh bench.
Hartnell and Crosby. Hartnell angles it off the far board. Sullivan hustles across and plays it out to center. It's a bouncy puck picked up by Pascal Dupuy. Waits. Trying to get it in front. Good stick by the one Flyer that was back there. That was Matt Carl that made the defensive play.
That was the fake. Dupuy was trying to get the goaltender Brizgal off to move, but when he faked, Carl came in and closed him down and knocked the puck away.
Now Dupuy will deflect this puck into the Philadelphia zone. Played around on the far side, intercepted by Malkin. Malkin by below the goal line. Turns back against Gustafson. Now Malkin turns, hands it off to Kunitz. Kunitz back to the line. Niskanen Makes a move there on Talbot, sends it back in deep. Malkin and Gustafson again, the one-on-one battle deep in the Philadelphia zone. And the puck is taken away. Gustafson has it. He waits and now backhands it, or tried to, into the Penguin zone. It ends up into the bench and out of play. Just past the halfway mark of the first, Flyers with a 1-0 lead. Time to go down to Brian Engblom for our Kia Motors coach interview with Philadelphia head coach Peter Laviolette.
Peter, you got the start that you want on the scoreboard, getting up 1-0 here, but 5-on-5, they've had a lot of the puck possession. How do you turn that around?
Well, it seems to be going both ways. They had a couple of in-zone shifts there where they were down on our end, but I thought we were pretty good defensively, so we do need to get it down there and generate a little bit of more offensive zone time.
Thanks, Peter.
All right.
Well, we'll see if the Flyers can do that. They have just two shots on goal. They went over 8.5 minutes between the two shots. Talbot sends his puck in deep. Niskanen and McCullough are there. And here is James Neal back the other way. Neal with a shot that is blocked aside by Bryzgalov. Now here's Malkin. Sends it back to the line. Ryan Strait moves it along for Kunitz. Kunitz angles it around behind the net. Here is Malkin with it. Knocked down by Couturier. Malkin kind of glanced toward the official, I think more hoping that there was going to be a call. It was a pretty solid play.
Malkin thought that puck was kept in for a moment, then realized Kunitz wasn't able to keep it inside the blue line and had to bail out.
Oberon wraps it around. His block here is Strait takes a hit from Wayne Simmonds. Now it's sent back deep into the Pittsburgh zone. Van Riemsdyk in on the forecheck. Englund able to clear as it deflects off of Gustafson's stick. So no icing here. Bryzgalov comes out to settle it down. Van Riemsdyk with it. Now for Matt Reed. Led all rookies in goal scoring during the regular season. As the puck squirts out to the near point, Carl slides it across, one-timer, misfired there by Gustafson. Dupre could not get it out of the zone. Now it's knocked down by Vitali, but held in at the line by the Flyers and sent just wide. Vitali has it again, and it's deflected by the Penguins out to center ice. Collision at center ice between Dupre and Simmonds. Now Stahl's pass. That missed the mark. And this is going to be an icing call against Pittsburgh as we take a look at our John Hancock pivotal moment, Brian.
Marc-Andre Fleury was under pressure after the first couple of games of the series, no doubt, but he was brilliant, and he had a couple of pivotal moments at the end of Game 5 there, especially on the power play by the Philadelphia Flyers. Look at these two on Danny Briere. And that's the kind of game Pittsburgh needs again from Fleury, because they will be under siege at times. This Flyers team can bring it offensively.
Now Jágr all the way back for Lilja. Played in toward Marc-Andre Fleury. He steers it away from Jágr, but here's Hartnell with it. Hartnell, Jágr, Giroux. Quick centering attempt there by Giroux, and the Penguins were alert to that. Now Fleury settles it down, moves it along the far side. Tyler Kennedy waiting there. And a collision at the blue line between Shen
and Matt Cook.
And Matt Cook.
And Cook is going to get the interference call. There's a lot of stuff that goes on at blue lines, 5-on-5 and on the power play, when you have players traveling parallel right along the blue line trying to get position and time it. And that's a good call. Matt Cook chops the stick of Brayden Schenn. That wasn't a smart penalty to take. Shen's trying to get into position. Matt Cook's trying to run a little bit of interference there. That's not a good penalty.
Philadelphia's power play, Brian, 11 for 20 in this series. In the two games in this building, they are 7 for 12.
That's crazy.
And already with a 1-0 lead, this is a huge penalty kill situation for the Penguins, even though it's very early. As Thiemann now slides it on the far side. Shot to the net, just missed as Voracek tried to go high glove.
And I don't see how you can't shade towards Giroux. Take him away, make somebody else beat you.
Voracek, Thiemann it. Voracek again quickly to Giroux. A one-timer! Oh, it's just getting across the goal.
It was on the line. The one-timer from Claude Giroux that made the difference. The puck was rolling right along the line. Marc-Andre Fleury had made the save initially on Claude Giroux, but he didn't know where it was. Giroux's on the right side of your screen. He's going to get into that slot area. There's the one-timer. Fleury barely makes the save. And look, see, it's trickled between his legs. Vitali does a really good job of initially keeping it from going in, but he inadvertently pushes it right back into the scoring area, and I believe it's Simmons who must get a hand on it. Simmons is fishing and looking. Oh, there it is.
Yeah,
that's
Hartnell.
Looking for a check. Oh, Hartnell. Hartnell comes in at the last minute.
Wow.
There it is. It leaks out. That may have rolled over initially, but that was Joe Vitale coming in at the last minute. He doesn't have a whole lot of choices there. He's got to try and whack it out as hard as he can. And talk about the full court press. Another power play goal there for the Philadelphia Flyers.
What a play by Scott Hartnell. You hear coaches always talking about go to the net, go hard, whatever you need to do. That is his second goal of this series. He had one in game five. An 18th career playoff goal for number 19, Scott Hartnell.
He had a tremendous regular season. He's got great talent on the power play, but he will go into the tough areas for sure. Simmons doing a nice job of taking McCulloch out of there. And then that's this football style. That's just want.
Now, one thing we've learned, Brian, in this series, two goal leads and three goal leads aren't safe. It's been the Penguins that have been the team that's been more guilty of giving up the multi-goal leads.
Well, when I interviewed James Neal before the game, I said, you expect a high-scoring game. He started to laugh. I don't know. I don't think anybody knows on either team what to expect one game to the next in this series.
Well, Peter Laviolette was asked yesterday in the off-day press conference about, you know, these high-scoring games and not typical of playoff hockey as we get an icing call here. And he said, you know what, I really don't care if we win 1-0 or we win 8-5 or we score 20 goals. It really doesn't matter. Now, he also said, do we have to be better defensively? Just as he mentioned to you, Brian, spend more time in the offensive zone, not give the Penguins so much time 5-on-5. But it's been incredible how the Flyers have been able to adapt to whatever the game presents them.
Sure, and really that's what you have to do. Ideally, coaches want low-scoring games. They want control. But if it's not there, you can't focus your players on trying to do something that is not going to happen. Sometimes you just got to roll with it. And the Flyers have got lots of firepower to do that.
Now Letang sends it in wide of Brizgalov, and on the far side it comes to Talbot. Talbot, look out, big hit coming there from Kunitz. And now right back into the zone, here comes Neil James. Neil with a shot that didn't miss by much on the stick side of Brizgalov. Now sent back in deep, deflected off the stick of Malkin. And Gustafson hands it off on the far side, and the Flyers out to center ice off of the stick of Wellwood. And now picked up by Cook, it goes back into the Pittsburgh zone. Letang with it. Shots are 7-4 Pittsburgh. But the important stat, Flyers with a 2-0 lead. Giroux unassisted and Hartnell from Giroux and Voracek. Here is Hartnell again. He's taken down. Referees looked at it, no call. As Stahl and Cook trying to get it into the Flyers zone and finally rolls to the corner. Stahl is there. Coburn ties him up. Now Kiemann hands it off to Hartnell. Hartnell out to center ice, gloved down by Claude Giroux. He ducked it back for Jágr. Jágr fans on the snapshot, turns, backhands it. Oh boy, that looks like it may have been headed into the net. Not sure if it was going to go over. Here's another chance. And looking skyward was Hartnell. He can't believe that didn't go in. Great pressure here by Hartnell and Jágr and Giroux. And the Flyers already have a 2-0 lead in this game six. And the story of the series continues to be the Philadelphia power play. Their 12th power play goal of the series. They're up 2-0.
From the first line of the Philadelphia Flyers, it started on the rush. The drop pass here to Jágr. Watch McCulloch. Great stick, not once, but twice. Comes right back on him again and doesn't allow it. But later on in that same shift, after Fleury knocked it behind the net, Crosby just barely deflects that pass on its way to Hartnell. Because of that, the puck was spinning. Hartnell couldn't get it all, and it went off the crossbar.
We have the Flyers for 5 scoring chances in this period. 4 of them have been generated by Giroux and Hartnell.
They are relentless on the puck. Their quickness and their confidence level, outstanding on that shift.
Now Briere with a shot to the net. Fleury knocked to the side, gave up a rebound, but it's Crosby who steers it ahead. And it's bounced in wide by Pascal Dupuis. Flyers get to it first, but it's taken by Crosby, and he missed it on a sharp angle. Held in at the line by the Penguins, and now Crosby. Right up by Gustafson, able to pull away from the check, sends it back on Brizgalov. Loose puck is flipped up high on the glass by Carl. Briere knocks down Pascal Dupuis, and that draws a reaction from the crowd. Braden Schenn starts it back. Far side. This is outside. Briere. Oh, good play by, or was it a penalty? We're going to get a tripping call. We'll get to that call in just a moment as we remind you the NBC Sports Network begins unprecedented coverage of the 138th Run for the Roses featuring classic derby races, draw for post position, and insider access. It all leads up to the Kentucky Derby Sunday, May 5th on NBC.
Braden Schenn with a great pass to Briere right at the blue line. Look how Briere uses his feet. Now Dupuis comes across and makes the initial really good play by sticking his stick in there. But you saw how his momentum caused his leg to whip and slip in behind Danny Briere, and he kicked out the feet from underneath. That's a good call.
Brian, I know confidence is a big part of a power play. Have you seen a power play more confident than this one?
No, I mean, they
in recent history, it's just unreal.
Yeah, these numbers are just staggering for them. Philadelphia just changes the look all the time, too. They get the puck to their main guys, and they open up seams all the time. A lot of it because of this guy, Giroux, so good with the puck.
Yeah, he just showed Matt Cook some work with the stick to keep it away from the Pittsburgh forward as it goes down low. Simmons back up the boards for Giroux. Just missed Hartnell with a diagonal seam pass, and it's recovered back in the Philadelphia zone with just over 3 minutes remaining here in the first period of Game 6.
With all the power play goals that Philly has scored, they've scored five of them within the last 20 seconds of a power play. Just when you think, we've done it, we've stopped them, they score.
Giroux, salary pass, Hartnell, one-timer sent wide. Voracek has it now. Voracek to the side of the net. Fleury stopped that. Now it comes to Giroux. Little Giroux out top there for Thiemann, and Thiemann gets it back from Giroux. Far side, one timer on the way, saved by Fleury. Rebound set to the front. Bouncing puck. Simmons had a couple of pops at it, but couldn't get it on goal. And now Pascal Dupuis will send it all the way back down the ice.
That is brilliant puck movement again by the Flyers. No wonder it's so tough to keep track of all of them. When somebody gets into the scoring area, the puck arrives at exactly the same time. Guys don't stand there all the time and are easy to cover. Whoever the open man is, he gets the puck.
Bouncing puck came off the back of the netting. Derek Engler gets to it for the Penguins. And we're down to that magic 20 seconds remaining in the power play. It's knocked out to center ice, so the Flyers are going to have to regroup here. That was a big clear for Pittsburgh as the zone time for Philadelphia has just been dangerous. With this man advantage as Jagr hands it off now to Briere. 5 seconds left in the Pittsburgh penalty. Here's Briere, hands it off for Schenn. Schenn to Jagr, out of the box comes Dupuis. Now to Jagr, right back to Carl with a shot, up high, loose puck in front of an open net. Jagr pokes at it and it goes to the far corner.
Jaromir Jagr, always dangerous. Jagr is one of only two players who has points in all five games. Coming into this one, he and Stahl were the only two.
Yep, goal and six assists. Leading the entire playoffs in assists, number 68. Coming into action today, Van Riemsdyk pulls it out in front of Fleury off the near boards. It's picked up by Crosby. Just over a minute remaining here in the first period. Far side, Malkin bursts to speed. Crosby picks it up, wanted to get it to the front. And that was blocked by Kimmo Thiemann. Now Couturier waits. That's deflected, sent back toward Fleury. Intercepted by Couturier. Sends it back to the line. Rink wide for Thiemann at top of the circle. Far side now for Couturier. He and Brian straight run into each other. And now the Penguins settle it down with half a minute remaining in the period.
And there's certainly nothing wrong with the five-on-play of the Philadelphia Flyers. Boy, they have dominated. They've come with shift after shift in the Pittsburgh zone.
Now Neal trying to go one-on-four. Lilja separates him from the puck. Under 20 seconds left in the period. in this crowd, almost all of them dressed in their orange and black colors. As Gustafson plays it ahead, Jágr deflects it. Now they all come to their feet for the final couple of seconds of this first period.
And Orpik with a shot on Jágr here right by the benches, right in front of me, basically. And that's what has the tempers really flaring here. Jaromir Jágr with a dirty look back at Orpik, wondering who it was. Brooks Orpik is the one that early on in the game, he had a big hit on Briere. And then after Jágr had redirected, it's actually a 1-2 punch. That was Neal that came in from behind. Jágr identifying both of them.
Day two for our first intermission here on NBC Sports. Lee McHugh and Mike Milbury will talk about the Flyers' fast start. And how about the Caps' pleasant surprises as they have the 3-2 series lead against the defending Stanley Cup champion Bruins. Game six of that series coming up following us here. But we got a lot more hockey to play. At the end of 20, it's 2-0 Flyers. Liam and Mike on the other side of this.
Hey everyone, welcome to your intermission report. Liam McHugh with Mike Milbury. After 20 minutes of action from Philadelphia, the Flyers hold a 2-0 lead. Claude Giroux putting on an absolute clinic. He set a new franchise record for points in a playoff series with 13. And Mike, he seemed to set the tone 5 seconds in.
I don't know why any coach wouldn't put their best players on the ice to start a hockey game. And certainly Peter Laviolette knows that Claude Giroux is his best player. And what a statement this is. This says, I came to play hockey. Bang, right off the get-go, he levels Sidney Crosby, the opposite team's captain and best player. Bang, airborne. This one means I mean business, and everybody gets the message right off the bat. And if that weren't enough, watch Giroux 32 seconds into the hockey game rip it past Marc-Andre Fleury. The Flyers have come to play. Claude Giroux is leading him in that direction. Interesting start to this game.
5 seconds in the big hit, 32 seconds in the goal, but was it a defense-first mentality that sort of carried them over the last 19 and a half minutes?
It's about time, right? I mean, it's been so wild, so open in this series that Peter Laviolette, who saw a lot of these stretch passes catch his defense unaware in the last game, made some adjustments. But the biggest thing is they're paying attention. Right there, Carl on, makes a good play. There's Thiemann in one-on-one. Watch Gustafson on Malkin. No trouble handling the big man and the probable MVP of this series. This is good defense by Couturier. Sorry there. Watch the defense. Three back. Cook takes the interference call. Right. They're on the power play. Great call by the official. Is it a full they get Philadelphia? Pittsburgh's got to get their act together.
And a rare attaboy for the officiating.
Absolutely.
They deserve it.
Call them as I see
them. And you know what? Maybe the defense is helping Ilya Bryzgalov find the peace in his soul. No goals in the first period. Still to come, the Stanley Cup trouble to Washington against the Caps.
Like this, every game's been tough with these guys. You know, they're not gonna quit.
Some of the sights from the first period of this game six of the Eastern Conference quarterfinals, the Stanley Cup playoffs presented by Geico here on NBC. Dave Strader in the booth, Ryan Engblom, our man inside the glass, Liam and Mike back in the studios, and of course this is just the start of great hockey coverage here today on NBC Sports with Boston and Washington game six coming up from our nation's capital. Dan Bylsma came out of the locker room before anybody else and stood on the bench by himself, Brian, for a good 2 or 3 minutes, so I'm sure there wasn't a whole lot that had to be said.
Yeah, he's usually an early arriver out there on the bench. His timing seems to be like that. He gets comfortable out here. I think he likes those few moments alone out there on the bench after having talked to his team.
So the Flyers controlling from behind their own net. They struck early in period one, just 32 seconds in. Remember, the team that has scored first has lost each game in this series. As we have an icing call, take a look at our board update. Giroux, a goal and an assist, leads the playoffs now in terms of assists with 7 and points with 13. Second power play goal of the series for Scott Hartnell. 25 first period goals ties an NHL record for one series.
Now the top three power play guys points-wise for Philly, Jágr, Hartnell, and Giroux, all with 5 points apiece in the power play in this series.
Entering attempt there for Neal. He was cruising in front, but the pass never got through as Malkin. Back to the line, Letang. Angles it off the far boards. James Neal is there. Now here is Malkin. Malkin tried to get it out to the slot. It caroms out of the stick of Kunitz. Sent out now to Brooks Orpik. Far side. Malkin tried to get it to the front of the net. Now James Neal again. That deflects to the corner. Sent back to the front. Just missed the stick of Malkin. And Hartnell starts it back. Hands it across for Giroux, and that play was just offside.
One of the differences I think that Pittsburgh's going to have to make in this second and third periods is they're going to have to play better man-on-man inside their own zone in front of Marc-Andre Fleury, especially when they come up against the Giroux line. Whether it's Giroux line on the power play or five-on-five, they are so good at moving in and out of holes, and I think playing sort of a zone defense for Pittsburgh isn't going to work. You're going to have to pick up those guys and be right on their stick, or it's going to be in the back of your net.
And Pittsburgh, Brian, really hasn't tested Ilya Bryzgalov yet.
No, they haven't. They had good puck possession time, especially 5-on-5 early on in that first period, but they didn't get to the net very often.
Now Tiemann backs up and slides it across. Braden Coburn, Voracek, took a hit there from Matt Cook. Now Tiemann plays it around. Matt Cook gets a stick on it, puts it out between the circles, scramble for the puck. As Tiemann had lost his stick, he picks it back up, but he gloved it ahead. And now it's out to center ice, and Shen in front of the Flyer bench, getting some help from Brière, who overskates. And it's back out to center ice. Tyler Kennedy has it there. Hands it off now to Jordan Staal. Staal top of the circle, and that's blocked up out of the netting and out of play. Let's go inside the glass, presented by Progressive Insurance. Here's Brian.
Well, we talked about Claude Giroux and how he set the tone from the first couple of seconds of this game, but it's the whole Giroux line that was the story in that first period. There's the hit by Giroux seconds into the game, and then Giroux's goal. That was a beautiful move and shot. But look at Hartnell in on the forecheck there, and then Jágr on top of the puck. This line was relentless. They gave Pittsburgh fits. That's what I'm talking about, an example right there. How does Hartnell get open in the slot like that? Lots of Penguins around in the area. In the area is not good enough against that line here in this game.
9 goals, 16 assists in this series for the Hartnell, Giroux, Jágr trio. Jágr, of course, in the Stanley Cup playoffs for the first time since 08 when he was with the Rangers after his hiatus over in the KHL. Here's a shot by Orpik right through. Save made by Bryzgalov. Now it goes back to the line, Englund. That deflected off a Flyer, and that Reed lost his stick. Pascal Dupuis rolls it back in deep. Crosby, Giroux leaning on him. Now Crosby gets it back. It deflects to the line. Orpik able to hold it in, sends it far side. Crosby backhands it toward the net. It was blocked, cleared around by Gustafson, waiting for it. Orpik tried to get it toward the Flyer goal, but it's knocked away, and Giroux starts it back now. Angles it off the far boards, picked up by Van Riemsdyk. Puts on the brakes against Englund. Now for Simmons. Orpik ties him up. Oh, Giroux spinning away from Dupuis. Had that stick in there momentarily, but quickly got it out to avoid a penalty. And Simmons couldn't corral it along the end boards. Couturier with a hit on Dupuis. Now up the boards. Coburn with a shot, sails wide of Fleury. Tiemann sends it back to the corner. Sullivan off the stick of Talbot. Entering pass, rolls all the way out to the far point. The Flyers were looking to make a change, so back the other way now. Neal drops it for Malkin, who overskates it. Neal again, now pushes it in deep. Kunitz with a hit on the forecheck. Now it comes to Neal. Neal with a shot, well wide as it went through Andreas Lilja. Neal takes a quick look over his shoulder. 40 goal scorer during the regular season, James Neal, and signing a huge contract extension.
He's played hard and physical in this series too. In fact, too physical at times, and ended up getting suspended for one of the games in this series. He's their biggest shooter too.
Yep. He missed game 4 of this series. And as the puck comes free and the Flyers back the other way, three of them into the offensive zone and the play just offside.
Third guy high in the offensive zone means you get scoring chances, but it also means you're the defensive guy. It was Talbot on that last play. He comes over and covers up there just when Malkin had ducked the check by Van Riemsdyk along the wall right here. There's the duck, and there's the attempt at Malkin to take the puck and go on a rush. But Talbot, realizing the situation, seeing what Van Riemsdyk was doing, Max Talbot knows Evgeny Malkin extremely well. They were teammates for years. That's a terrific defensive play in the offensive zone.
66 playoff games Talbot played in a Penguin uniform. He's had a full season now to get used to being a member of the Orange and Black, and six regular season meetings, and now a sixth meeting here in the playoffs as Kennedy with a chance, never got to the net. Vitali sent it just wide of Brzgalov. Now Vitali again, and it knocked off the stick, and Voracek starts it back. Three Flyers against two, hustling back though as Adam trying to even it up. Breer with a shot, save! And one of the Penguins goes flying into the net.
The prey. The Penguins defense were doing a good job at standing up at their own blue line, but what a brilliant pass by Voracek right at the blue line, all the way across the ice, almost the entire width, right onto the stick of Danny Breer. Watch this, right at the blue line there, all the way across. And it gives Danny Breer a great chance. When you can make passes like that, you can see how the Pittsburgh defense come over and have to fill the middle of the ice. You give Danny Breer a chance, and then you see the prey going sliding into the net. The fans don't like it here. They think it was intentional. He's trying to recover to the front of the net because he's afraid of a pass to Shen. He leaves his feet, can't stop his momentum, and knocks the netting off.
Puck to the far side of the Pittsburgh zone. Dupuis tried to play it back for Crosby, but it was knocked down by Coburn. Now on the counterattack, here's Jagr. Darts to the middle, gets the shot away, and a save by Fleury. Now Jagr again, hikes it through the leg, Giroux. Jordan Staal is there, and he clears it.
This line creates so much. If there isn't at least one guy back for Pittsburgh, the Philadelphia top line is really toying with them in the offensive zone. This one is literally shocking, especially to Marc-Andre Fleury. I don't know if it was deflected, it was close, but the penetration is partly a factor, but this one shouldn't go in. McCulloch does get a stick on it. I think it did change direction on it. The Penguins were a little bit soft and backing off there and allowing a penetration almost to the tops of the circle. But Fleury, who has his glove up and seems ready, simply isn't able to get a beat on it. And everybody was just stunned, including Fleury. The interesting thing is, though, Dave, I watched him in the warm-up right near the end, and he likes to get a couple of shots into his glove. There was a shot by McCulloch, took a slap shot, and he just plain missed it, almost exactly like that one. Although, I give him the benefit of the doubt there, that I think that one was deflected just a little bit.
First career playoff goal for the 23-year-old. Eric Gustafson, he played his college hockey 3 years at Northern Michigan, and he has given the Philadelphia Flyers a commanding, if you can use that term in this series, 3-0 lead. Here's Neal with a chance, trying to drag it to the front. And he did a pretty good job of doing that, but Brzgalov made the stop. Now on the angle, Kunitz is stopped by Brzgalov as it's cleared around, and Letang sends it across. Backhanded up the wall and picked up now by Couturier, runs into Staal. Now here is Staal, that is trickling in on Brzgalov. Marc-Andre Fleury was one of just two goalies in the league with over 40 wins this season, but the Flyers have made him look average at times in this series. Gustafson makes it 3-0.
Dan Bylsma is normally a very calm guy, but he senses this team needs a good talking to. This is during the commercial break. Everybody in. Everybody.
He gave it to him pretty good. There's so much noise in here, it's impossible to hear what he says, but I could definitely hear him saying, using the words refocus, let's go, and getting in literally in everybody's face, let's get going, trying to get the energy level up, snap the fingers, let's go here, boys.
Off the draw, Neal. That shot was blocked and back the other way. Coburn tried to play it ahead, and it rolls in behind the Pittsburgh goal. Pittsburgh, after winning their Stanley Cup in 2009, and of course they went to the finals the year before that in 08, out in the second round in 2010, and out in the first round last year. This is stunning what we've seen so far. Last year they didn't have Crosby or Malkin in that first round loss at the hands of Tampa Bay, as Niskanen now hands it off for Letang. He spins away from pressure. Centering pass by Neal, picked up by Malkin. He hit the goal post to the left of Chris Golub. You can hear it up here. But Pittsburgh, after a talking to from their coach, putting out some pressure. Now it's intercepted. We're going to have a penalty coming. And it looks like it's going to go against the Flyers.
Yeah, it's going to be a hooking penalty. Malkin did have the chance down low, but he had to go to his backhand first and then pull it to the forehand right here. The puck comes loose. By the time he pulls it in, he just clinked that one, looked like right off the crossbar in the post. By his own admission, Evgeny Malkin said he's been kind of average really in this series. That was one of his better chances for sure. And then there's the penalty at the very end of it. That's Kimmo Tiimonen. 2 minutes for hooking as he gets up in under the arm. I mean, it's early in the game to start using words crucial, but this one I would say is a crucial power play. If nothing else, you have to get some momentum seized back from the Flyers.
Niskanen with a shot, didn't get very far as it was deflected and then hammered all the way back down the ice by Matt Carl. Tiimonen in the box. Power play number two for the Pittsburgh Penguins, and offside the call as Cook tried to get back. Well, check out NHL Extra on NBCSports.com and NHL.com for full DVR control of today's game. Plus, chat live with the experts from Pro Hockey Talk. Go to NBCSports.com or NHL.com to learn more.
These type of situations where you lean on your big stars to gain control of the game. Crosby and Malkin out there on the power play need the puck on their tape.
Sullivan for Letang. Malkin with some speed takes it wide on Coburn. Coburn got a piece of the puck. Matt Carl wraps it around. It's blocked by Crosby. Malkin back out to the right point. It skips away from Letang. Talbot's going to get to this puck. He is hit hard by Letang into the boards, but it's taken away. A shot here by Giroux. And that was stopped by Fleury.
Those two are deadly on the penalty kill. Talbot's got a couple of shorthanders. Giroux's got a shorthander. You can't make mistakes like that if you're Pittsburgh.
Two of Talbot's goals in this series have been shorthanded. As this play is offside, special teams have been such a big part, Brian, of what the Flyers have done in this series.
Yeah, we talked a lot about the power play, and for good reason. But three shorthanded goals to add insult to injury for the Philadelphia Flyers. It's been the combination of Talbot and Giroux. Giroux's in the center of everything. That's why he's leading everybody in point. Some of it is just good old-fashioned work. The last shift that was out there was Talbot, who took a big hit from Letang along the boards to start the play, and he got it right out to Giroux for another great chance.
Here is Reed now with some room down the far side. Reed with a short-handed chance, pulls up and hammers it hard, but high off the glass, and the Penguins' Crosby take it away. Backhand shot, Fleury the save, and the Penguins have come away with it.
Couturier, one-on-one there against Crosby. Crosby tried to beat him.
Malkin, wait, shoots, scores! Evgeny Malkin puts it through for his Golub. And the Pittsburgh Penguins, Brian, get more than momentum on the power play. They get on the scoreboard.
You could almost consider that a two-goal swing as Philadelphia almost scores shorthanded, and then Pittsburgh comes right back. Malkin gets a little bit of a window there, and he waits for a couple of legs to open. He shoots it in between Lilia's legs. Grizgalov has got, there's the turnover by Couturier. Crosby does a good job of recovering there. But it's a save by Fleury that really bails him out. Crosby's directing traffic. Malkin gets the chance.
And Brizgalov just never really saw that one. There was a little bit of a V, a window down low. Malkin saw it. Goal scorers do.
Third goal of the series for Malkin, who had two in the 10-3 blowout win in game four here. Scoreless in games one and five so far in this series. But a power play goal for Malkin, unassisted. And now the Penguins come right back 5-on-5, but the Flyers able to send it out center ice. Briere pushes it right side. Voracek kicks it deep. Briere with a shot. Save, rebound right to the goal line. The Flyers are celebrating, and the officials are talking. The red light came on.
Danny Briere started celebrating right away. Fleury made the initial save, and I think the puck even hit the shaft of his stick and seemed to trickle behind him. Looks like they're going to take a look at this one again. The Flyers just turning momentum around, get it into the paint from the bad angle. Now there's the rebound
skate.
Off the leg, and then Fleury, it definitely goes over the line.
Yeah.
Orpik gets a stick on it, but he inadvertently puts it into his own net or goes off the inside of the leg. Wow, Orpik was trying to fish it out here. Look at Marc-Andre Fleury. He's trying to feel it. He's trying to sense where it is. That one was definitely in. The question here will be the referee's interpretation. Did he blow the whistle? Did he intend to blow the whistle?
I'm guessing that's not the case because they are looking at review, which whether he was going to blow the whistle or not is not reviewable. They would be looking to just confirm that the puck did cross the line because it looked like Kelly Sutherland, as he came into the picture, perhaps was blocked by the stick of the Pittsburgh player who was fishing it out.
That definitely was over the line, no doubt.
Here's Kelly Sutherland.
Upon video review, the puck completely crosses the goal line. We have a good goal on the ice.
Minute and 26 seconds after Malkin gets Pittsburgh on the board, the Flyers come back. And a leaky goal that finds its way through Fleury. Yes, a little bit of bad luck with Orpik's stick. Kennedy couldn't fish it out of there in time.
And a lot of stuff going on while they were taking a look at that, too. Claude Giroux, who has been fully engaged since the first couple of seconds, got into it with James Neal over here near the end of the Pittsburgh Penguins bench. A little bit of jawing for sure, pushing back and forth while they're reviewing it. That's a big goal for the Flyers. Takes huge momentum away from Pittsburgh.
Briere gets credit for the goal. That is his fifth of these playoffs. Voracek and Carl getting the assists on the goal by Briere. And Philadelphia has the quick answer again. 47th career playoff goal for Danny Briere. As this will be icing against the Flyers.
What a momentum breaker there by Danny Briere and the Flyers. So, I mean, that was just good old-fashioned. Get it to the net. Let's spend some time in the offensive zone. And it ends up in the back of the net. Pittsburgh a little sloppy, and mostly Marc-Andre Fleury just having trouble controlling the puck, not being able to keep it in sight. He was literally trying to feel that one as it was going in off his pads.
Danny Briere, after a career-high 34 goals in the 10-11 season, dipped down to 16 as he missed a dozen games, but boy, has he found his scoring touch. And here comes Giroux again, puts it off of Fleury's stick. Fleury was spun around and was actually facing the end boards at one point. Now Neal. The thing that's so shocking about this, Brian, you and I saw the Penguins quite a bit during the season, is that when the Penguins were really on their game, their structure was so good.
Yes.
As Letang shot his block.
Yeah, their structure on their penalty kill, they were top three in the league. When it comes to penalty kill, big hit along the wall, they were going to get another penalty.
Yeah, I believe it's going to go to Hartnell. And he's a little bit shaken up from the contact as he goes to the box. Pittsburgh on the power play. They trail by three. Time now for the Edward Jones FaceTime interview with Pittsburgh coach Dan Bylsma. Here's Brian.
Dan, in the position you're in right now on the scoreboard, what was the message to your team? What's important?
We just got to get back focused playing here. We can't get caught up in the emotion here. We know we're in a bad predicament here. But we got to go 5 minutes at a time, start with this power play.
Is scoring chances the most important thing for you?
We got to get goals here. We know we have to come back and get three. We've done that before. We've gotten four against this group here before in a period. So got to get back here, focus, playing our game, starting power play goal here.
Thank you.
Dan Bylsma's voice may not last to the end of this game. Here comes Pittsburgh with the power play opportunity.
I'm sure most of that came from when he called the team all together because it's so loud in here.
Now Letang wanted to hand it off, but the Flyers were there. Came in and tying it up along the boards. Coburn tried to dig it free, slapped away from Malkin. Sullivan came down the boards. And it's cleared now by Giroux all the way down the ice. Lurie hands it off to Letang. Shots are 22-16, Pittsburgh. Philadelphia has scored on 25% of their shots. Look out, this puck up into the Pittsburgh bench and out of play. Get live NBC national games right on your Verizon 4G LTE smartphone with Verizon 4G LTE NHL Game Center Premium. Call Star NHL to download today, only from Verizon.
Right now, the Flyers doing a real good job of keeping the Penguins along the wall, facing the glass. They can't get in cleanly and get set up.
Puck deflects off a Flyer, but out to center ice. Sullivan for James Neal. Sidesteps Coburn. Shot changed direction. Brzgalov fought that one off, rolling in toward the blue paint. And Brzgalov scoops it up.
Good job by Neal there, right at the blue line. Sidesteps the check and is able to get some penetration. Then somebody's loose stick in there really threw a wrench into the situation, really. Here's Neal with that move. Makes a move on Coburn, gets it to the net, and then there's the loose stick. So Brzgalov has that distraction. And you could tell he literally fought that one off. The puck is just flopping around there, and the loose stick is in there as well, too. But in the end of it, Flyers get a hold of it.
Back to the line, knocked away from Malkin, and Sullivan circles away from Claude Giroux. 45 seconds remaining in the Philadelphia penalty to Scott Hartnell as Malkin whips it across Letang, far side Crosby. Crosby out to Malkin. Oh, he's so important to handle those passes cleanly. Some of it's the ice conditions, bouncing pucks. You only have a split second opportunity. Doesn't take much for that chance to go away. Carl off the glass, held in by the Penguins. Here's Niskanen. Slides it across for Letang. 15 seconds left to the Hartnell penalty. Now Niskanen again. Wrist shot save made by Brzgalov. And he gives a little jab to James Neal with the goal stick as he went by. Niskanen for Letang again. Crosby out to the line. Letang. Hartnell steps out of the box. Pressure still though for the Penguins. Niskanen shot save. Good puck in front of Brzgalov. And the Flyers do a good job to send it wide.
Really good puck movement there by the Penguins right in the dying seconds of that power play to get it to the front of the net.
7.5 remaining here in the second period. Flyers trying to close out this series. Lurie trying to play it around and it ends up deflecting off a couple of Flyers and out of the netting, out of play.
Malkin had deflection right in the paint area, but it went up high and then it'll go diagonal and then down low right to the front of the net. There's the puck movement at the end. It ends up in the feet of Malkin. Malkin's a big body, of course, and he's the leading goal scorer in the National Hockey League this year. Brzgalov with the original save and then the ricochet effect there. Matt Carl does a good job of getting a stick on it, and Malkin just can't quite get the handle on it.
Mentioned this is the sixth series all time between these two rivals. The Flyers won the first three back in 89, 97, and 2000. Pittsburgh had won the previous two in 08 and 09. They met in back-to-back seasons. Gustafson for Briere. And it's backhanded along the boards. Fleury just did get there to knock it away from Braden Schenn. Pascal Dupuis rolls it out to center ice. Flyers have it again. deflected deep into the Pittsburgh zone. Fleury runs it off. Vinnie McCulloch. Brother Milan in the playoffs. What a story they've been, the Ottawa Senators. 3-2 lead over the top seed in the entire playoffs, the New York Rangers.
Jason Spezza coming up with a big game. He had no goals going into that game. Gets both of them last night.
Orpik slides it across McCulloch. Now for Neal off of his skate. And here's Claude Giroux with it. Sends it ahead for Hartnell. Waits, drops it back to Giroux. Makes a little move, now gets a shot away into the glove of Fleury, and he will hold it there.
Well, you look for your big stars, especially if you're the Pittsburgh Penguins, to get you back into this one down on the scoreboard. Sidney Crosby has had it tough tonight. Right off the bat, he gets hit by Giroux. He hasn't had any extra time or extra room out there. They are playing him hard, man for man, no matter where he is in that offensive zone. He has to work for everything. The guy does have tremendous balance and quickness, but when you got somebody draped all over you all the time, and what you notice here is it's somebody different. It's just not one shadow. It's a different guy every time you see a replay there, whether it's Claude Giroux, who he's been up against head-to-head and is again right now, or Couturier at times. The defense has played him tight. You got to stay close to 87.
Now Giroux sends it back off the end boards. Hartnell angled to the boards hard by Derek Englund. Outer shot steered aside by Marc-Andre Fleury. Now Crosby again. Jágr on him. Crosby plays it ahead. Now it's angled off the boards and sent back into the Philadelphia zone. Hartnell gets a stick on it, then got some help from Lilja, who finished the job clearing the zone. Now Gustafsson. Big hit there from Cook. Out of the high slot. Wade plays it along the boards now for Kennedy. Under 5.5 remaining here in the second period. Kennedy with Giroux leaning on him. Now Malkin all the way out to the blue line. Carries it on the backhand, tried to get it to the front. It's blocked by Jágr, and he calmly clears it off the boards and softly back into the Pittsburgh zone.
You can see how little room Malkin gets too, trying to gain some speed, trying to look for a chink in the armor there. There was nothing.
Now Lilja tries to play it ahead. Everybody stopped as if that puck hit the netting, which it did. Fires with a 4-1 lead. Little burn it to the ground from Nickelback. Of course, partnering up with the National Hockey League, they'll be part of the NHL Awards in Las Vegas in June after this is all over with, the Stanley Cup playoffs. Dave Trader along with Brian Engblom and the rest of our crew. Liam McHugh, Mike Milbury back on the studio. They'll be coming your way in our second intermission, just a few moments away. Coburn, that canceled up the boards. Straight, able to hold it in momentarily for the Penguins, but it's kicked out, and here's Talbot with it. Played ahead by Eric Wellwood. Scoops in. Avoids most of the hit from Niskanen. Now Couturier. Holds it back in deep. Centering pass. Fleury was down. Picked up by Couturier, and he fires it just wide.
Couturier has been a terrific story in this series, too, for what he's done with Evgeny Malkin. He's been all over him this series. He's frustrated him a lot, and he's turned over some pucks and had some offensive chances in this game alone.
Now Coburn. That shot was blocked by Kunitz, who was right in front of him. Puck is taken away, though, by Shen. But Philadelphia is relentless, Brian. As soon as they lose the puck in the offensive zone, they're already in the act of getting it back. Here's Voracek. Hands it off. Shen with a shot. Changes direction. Misses the net.
That took Niskanen's stick right out of his hand, and that's what caused the deflection to go wide of the net.
Now Niskanen working over the back of the leg of Shen, which the crowd was reacting to. Great, plays it around on the near side. Flyers are going to get to it first. Matt Carl works it along. Taken away by Stahl, sends it across for Crosby. Crosby now for Tyler Kennedy. He is hit hard along the boards. The puck pops free. Briere gets to it. Backhands it deep into the Pittsburgh zone as we're under 3 minutes remaining here in the second period. Now stall for Crosby. Top of the circle. Gets it back to Staller. Tried to. And Bylsma trying all kinds of different line combinations. Staller and Crosby together. Here with Tyler Kennedy as the puck is taken away by the Flyers and Giroux. Little flip pass. Voracek lost it. Picked up by Giroux and a save by Fleury.
Giroux is just always where the puck is. Even when it's a loose puck, it always seems to come back to him like a magnet. But the defensive structure of the Philadelphia Flyers, rather, is really incredible to see. Pittsburgh doesn't get any room out there.
Icing against the Flyers here on the touch-up by Orpik.
We showed you Sidney Crosby's evening before. We'll show you Malkin. Malkin coming into your screen now. This is the shift before. Now he's got the puck. He'll loop up top. And look at the Flyers track him. Look at him. Trying to find an opening. Can't find an opening. It's out of the zone. And then going into the front of the net. Look at the traffic in front of the net. He gets pulled down a little bit. They're working him over all the time. Wearing him out. As they say, it takes a village. And the village is sharp.
Frey sends it out to the line. McCulloch fakes the shot. He got Hartnell down, now trying to get it through, but it's blocked by Giroux. You mentioned, Brian, he's everywhere the puck is, even when it comes to blocking shots.
Yeah, there was no chance of getting that puck to the net from the blue line. Even with that fake by McCulloch, he did a nice job on it, but then he looked up and just saw a wall of bodies between him and the net.
Here, a lot of coaches talking about layers in all three zones, and the Flyers are showing that here this afternoon.
Yeah, the Penguins in a situation like that for McCulloch, he may have to start using the end wall and get rebounds off of there, try to open things up a little bit.
Now McCulloch kept that puck from getting deep, but the Flyers pick it up center ice, lob it in on Fleury. It's in his glove. He gets the sarcastic cheer from the Philadelphia crowd. Coming this May, don't miss the world's best golfers. They gather at TPC Sawgrass for the Players Championship. Coverage begins May 10th through the 13th on Golf Channel and NBC. Always one of the great golf tournaments of the year.
At the end of that last shift that we saw, Malkin trying to get to the front of the net and getting knocked down, you can see what this series has done to him.
Yeah.
He is the leading goal scorer, point producer in the regular season. He's got a lot of pressure on him. He tries to produce all the time. The Flyers have shut him down, and that frustration builds when they're down in this crucial game, down by a couple of goals.
109 points, Art Ross Trophy, the second of his career. As Simmons, now for Van Riemsdyk, knocked away from him, Sullivan back the other way. Less than a minute now remaining here in this second period. Sullivan trying to find some room, squeezing along the boards. Matt Reed not giving an inch. Backhands it ahead, it comes back to Reed. Kicked out by Staal, and the play is offside at the Pittsburgh line. Don't forget to stay with us for the Discover Card second intermission. The Flyers in closeout mode, and the Canucks not done yet. And Liam and Mike will discuss that Western Conference series.
The amount of work that Malkin and Crosby and all the Penguins have to put in just to get the puck inside the zone now is really striking. We talked about last couple of games coming into this one where Pittsburgh had done a lot of good work 5-on-5. Well, that's been taken away from them here.
And there's still some hockey to be played for sure in this first round, but can you imagine that anybody would have thought that powerhouse names, as Letang shot here is blocked, like Detroit, Vancouver, San Jose, Pittsburgh, the New York Rangers, could all go out in the first round? I mean, just incredible what we've seen here in the first round of these playoffs.
That's today's NHL. As they say, just get in. Just get in the playoffs and see what happens.
Now the Penguins are arguing what happened here.
A weird skip to the puck, and it hit, I think that's Voracek's foot on the line change. And so Pittsburgh is arguing vehemently. Probably trying to get a too many men on the ice penalty. Looks like the result of it is we're just going to get a face-off here outside the zone.
Right in front of the Philadelphia bench with 15.6 seconds. And they're going to do this one again.
Some stuff going on between Malkin and Couturier right in front of the bench there. Petey Laviolette didn't like it. That's that matchup again. Couturier doing a heck of a job against Malkin, and Malkin's frustration level has boiled over at times. He's taken some retaliatory penalties, including last game, and I think he gave the Couturier a little bit of a shot before that last faceoff.
Aletang weaving through players in the neutral zone, gets it into the Flyers end, sends it deep for James Neal. Neal taken down by Coburn. Now Coburn backhands it off the boards, and that'll do it as the horn sounds to end the second period of play. It was 2-0 after one. Malkin got the only Pittsburgh goal on the power play to briefly make it 3-1. But the Flyers had the answers against Marc-Andre Fleury. Gustafson and Breer getting the goals for Philadelphia in the second. 4-1 Philadelphia, 20 minutes perhaps away from moving on to the second round. The Discover Car second intermission with Liam and Mike right after this.
Welcome to the Discover Card Intermission, brought to you by Discover. It pays to discover.
Hey everyone, welcome to your Discover Card Intermission Report. Liam McHugh with Mike Milbury. After 40 minutes of action from Philly, Flyers lead it 4-1. Mike, this series all about massive momentum swings. Coach's job at times to calm things down, perhaps shift the energy. Part of that's calling timeouts, but is part of that also using the TV timeouts?
You betcha. Really, I thought Dan Bylsma was spot on with his reaction. His team had just gone down 3-0, and something had to be done. And what had to be done was a wake-up call, and that's exactly what Bylsma did. This is not his normal behavior on the bench, but he had gathered everybody in, and he gave it to them. Right after that, they got on their horse and got ready to ride. Malkin hits the post, the penalty comes, and then it was Fleury with two big saves, shorthanded, that kept these guys alive, and right here it'll turn and go the other way. Coast to coast goes Malkin and zips it past Brizgalov, and now all of a sudden things have changed just seconds after the timeout and the call by Bylsma to get his troops together. And you know what, at that point, didn't you feel it?
Absolutely.
Felt like here it comes again.
Yeah, Malkin pumped his fist and you thought the Pens were back, but the Flyers' response was prompt. Danny Briere has 104 points in 103 career playoff games. Any surprise that he was the guy responding?
There shouldn't be any surprise, but it was a surprise to the Penguins that just seconds after they found their mojo, that Briere comes back and gets a lucky bounce here. Good play here, actually, by Voracek. This behind-the-back play at kind of a tough angle. Fleury starting to go from post to post, and it comes back and bangs off the defenseman's leg and just trickles over the back of the line from ecstasy to agony in just about 30 seconds. And this was, talk about momentum swings. It looked like it was going to be Pittsburgh's, and then all of a sudden, just as quickly, Briere's goal turns it around. Everything settled down at that point. I thought it was a very comfortable period for Philadelphia. Somehow, somebody's going to come up with a big play to start this third for Pittsburgh.
Yeah, that being said, if there's one team in this postseason you could pick down three goals going into the third period to make a comeback, would it be Pittsburgh?
No question about it. So many weapons, so many big game players, and so many guys who've been there before. They've got the experience. They've got the talent. Now they got to get the job done.
Still to come, the President's Trophy winners are hoping to avoid being impeached from the postseason. We'll preview Kings Canucks Game 5 next.
Brown on the forehand, fakes the shot. Schneider stopped him, and the Canucks still lead.
Big save at one end, and a rebound goal at the other.
The Vancouver Canucks season will continue.
Welcome back to the Eastern Conference Quarterfinals Game 6, the Stanley Cup Playoffs presented by Geico. Dave Strader along with Brian Engblom, our man inside the glass, Sidney Crosby, and the Penguins up against it with Giroux and the Flyers leading by three goals heading into the third period. Ilya Brizgalov really has not had to make any spectacular saves here this afternoon.
It's not going to get any easier for Pittsburgh to get to the front of the net in this third period either.
Now Orpik spinning away from Wellwood, and Orpik sets up now back behind his own net. With speed the other way is Neal. Neal cuts to the middle of the shot, fired wide. Now it comes to the line, Letang for Neal. Three orange and black jerseys surrounding him. Now it's knocked off the stick of Malkin. Picked up by Neal again, intercepted by Talbot. And he's patient with it.
That's a good opening shift, though, by Neal. Neal grabbed the puck, and he was going outside and wide. There's a shot that goes high and wide. But if Neal can get chances like that or create chances, it'll give a little bit of extra room for Evgeny Malkin without Malkin having the puck on his stick all the time and being surrounded.
Not good news for the Penguins as well is that the Flyers have been dominant in terms of scoring goals in the third periods of this series. They have scored 8 to the Penguins 2. Shot to the front. That was blocked and cleared ahead now for Hartnell, who starts it back the other way.
Pittsburgh's philosophy here has to be, let's just create some momentum. They're in that nothing to lose mode, down by 3 goals. Get out there, get the puck, try and get some momentum created, see if we can't sustain it against this Flyers team.
Now Giroux plays it along the end board. Jagr picks it up behind the net. Jagr looks to the front. Knocked down, a penalty coming against Pittsburgh. And it's going to be called now, and it's going to be a slashing call.
That won't help as Niskanen going to the box. The number one line of the Flyers just spending some time inside the offensive zone. Niskanen ends up with a chop right there, right across the back of the leg. Oh yeah, that was there was no accident about that one. He got Giroux right in the back of the knee there. The referees have been really on top of everything. They haven't let anything go. They don't want to at this point for sure. Giroux's obviously okay. He's right back out.
Third power play for the Flyers. They're 1-for-2, as we've mentioned a couple of times. 12 power play goals in this series, but the Penguins able to control this faceoff and send it back down the ice. It will be Tiemannin and Giroux on the points on the power play with Voracek, Simmons, and Hartnell up front. This puck though cleared by the Penguins, and Tiemannin back to get it. Jordan Staal right on him. Now Voracek. Across center ice into the Pittsburgh zone. Broken up momentarily by Adams, but Voracek recovers, comes to the front, backhand is stopped, and the Penguins able to clear.
Hartnell was going in behind the net, hoping to come out on the other side. He and Simmons exchanging a couple of words there afterwards, waiting for a timing situation to develop, but Simmons wasn't able to get him the puck when he wanted.
Now Jagr, burst of speed, right side. Breer with a shot, he didn't miss by much. Trying to go high short side on the glove side of Fleury. Reed hands it off to the corner. Jagr pushes it along for Schenn. Schenn tried to get it to the front. Two Penguins are there. Now Adams gets to it. Picked up by Letang, and he got it by the right skate of Matt Carl all the way down the ice.
Danny Breer loves getting those chances. Coming in a little late with speed. He comes in wide, and he'll take that shot. He's a precision shooter. He doesn't miss his corners very much, very often.
Now here is Reed. Around on the near side, Carl gets to it. Hits a stick, but the Flyers regain possession. Now it's intercepted by Cook, and he'll send it out to center ice.
Turn! Turn!
If nothing else, Philadelphia being on the power play. Just takes another 2 minutes off the clock for the Pittsburgh Penguins as Niskanen comes out of the box.
Yeah, this is about not making any mistakes for sure. Constant puck possession. Wait for your chance, and if nothing else, yeah, the clock's just running dry.
Now Couturier. What a matchup he has been against Evgeny Malkin in this series. McCulloch plays it off the board. Stretch pass finds its way to Malkin. Malkin looks to the front, but coming back there was Couturier.
Brilliant. Brilliant read by Couturier. He was in the middle of the ice. He saw Malkin. He had no chance to go over to Malkin, but he saw Kunitz coming late and just got in that passing lane.
Deflected deep behind Bergalov. He'll settle it down there. Around the boards, and it goes all the way back into the Pittsburgh zone, and the icing call is made here on the touch-up by Chris Letang.
Sean Couturier is a rookie, but he plays like he's been in the league about 10 years. Really smart. Watch him come back in the middle of the ice. And look, see him, he looked over to his left there just at the last moment, realized that Kunitz was the open guy. He got right in the passing lane. Malkin knew that Kunitz was there. Couturier really learning how to think like Malkin. He's been inside his head and in his back pocket this entire series. That's another good defensive play.
Knocked away from Niskanen by Hartnell. It'll be chased down by Letang. We played nearly 5 minutes here in the third period. It remains 4-1. Flyers lead the series 3-2. Niskanen far side, Letang. Puts it up on the glass around on the near side. Picked up by Kennedy. Backhand shot for Scott. Steers to the side. Angled off the boards by the Flyers, but Niskanen held it in, blocked in front of Bergalov, out to the line. Here's Letang. He fakes. He goes down as he was tangled up there with Jagr. Now here's Sullivan with it. Hands it off to Letang. Letang shot. Changes direction in front of Bergalov and sent wide. Pulled off the glass and all the way back into the Pittsburgh zone. It's going to roll right at Marc-Andre Fleury. So the icing negated. Pascal Dupuis. Rink wide for Mac Cook, just out of his reach. Coburn drops it back. Here's Briere. Angles it off the boards and it bounces off the stick of Ryan Strait. He's back to get it.
It's the little things like that. Coburn with a nice behind-the-back pass. And then Briere making sure it gets out of the zone. It's the little things like that that make a difference. That's the way the Flyers have played in this game. Not just the four goals they've scored, but their structure and their attention to detail.
Voracek, nice little flip outlet now to Reed. He takes it wide. We're behind Van Riemsdyk. And back the other way now comes Staal. Staal across the line. Takes it wide. On the backhand turns. Hands it off now. McCulloch. That was blocked and it's cleared off the boards and out to center ice. Back into the wire zone. Here's Bergalov playing it up the glass. Van Riemsdyk chips it. And Simmons had it knocked off his stick. Staal recovers. Dupre comes in, gets a weak backhander to Bergalov, easily steers aside.
You would expect Pittsburgh's defense to get engaged. I mean, they need offense from everywhere.
Loose puck in front of Bergalov momentarily, but the Flyers were the first one to get to it. Now Gustafson, who had the goal that really was the stunner, I think, so far in this game, the one that made it 3-0 in the second period.
Yeah, that was the shock value goal. There's no doubt about that. Gustafson getting the penetration, shooting that puck, and just stunned the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Take a look at the Lexus competitive edge in this series. The two big guns, Malkin the leading scorer in the regular season. Giroux is the leading scorer in these playoffs. Those 14 points are a new Flyer record for points in a series. Danny Briere had 12 points back in the Stanley Cup Final in 2010 against Chicago. And Bill Barber was the other to do it back in 1980. So Giroux in just a five-game series has set a new scoring mark in a playoff series and a lot of great history, of course, with the two Stanley Cup championships back in the 70s, Brian.
Yeah, he's stunning. It's a stunning performance, no doubt. He can play any kind of game you want, Claude Giroux.
Neal taken hard to the boards by Tiemannin at the very end of that shift. And nobody's really reacting, including Neal. 12:20 to go in the third. It's a three-goal lead. Frustration for Neal and the Penguins. Back at Wells Fargo Center here in Philadelphia. The NHL on NBC presented by Geico. Dave Strader along with Brian Engblom, our man inside the glass. Mike and Liam back in the studios. First game of our doubleheader with Game 6 coming up from Washington between the Capitals and the Bruins. And the Capitals with a chance to eliminate the defending Stanley Cup champions. Now Letang with a shot that's blocked high in the air, and it's gloved to the corner safely by Coburn. He takes a hit there from Malkin. Now Malkin out of the corner, gets a shot away. Save made by Brizgalov.
What an individual effort by Evgeny Malkin. He is fired up, trying to get something going. He was fired up in the last commercial break in front of his own bench, and this one is just all him coming out of the corner here. This is how good big man skills, makes a big hit, assesses the situation. Now watch this move coming out of the corner, and this is just all him wanted to get something done. A between the legs move, gets it to the paint. There's nobody there for a second chance. The Flyers doing a nice job of boxing out. Neal was there, but Neal couldn't get there in time. And in amongst all of that, Coburn will take a penalty as well. He's the one that got hit by Malkin when Malkin turned the puck over. So he ended up on the back side of him. And Coburn, knowing, having seen an awful lot of Malkin over the years, he knows how dangerous the guy can be walking out of the corner. So Pittsburgh here with the power play and chance for a little momentum.
Yep, still 12 minutes, 11:54 on the clock. That is an eternity with the talent that this Pittsburgh roster has.
They tried a last second change here. They wanted to get Neal out in the power play for Cook, but the referee said no.
Crosby sends it back to the line. Sullivan back to the Penguins captain. Now it's knocked down. Teeminen didn't get it by Crosby out to the line. Sullivan hammers a shot here. Blocker save for Skalov. Bouncing puck between the circles. Oh, Giroux may have a break. Letang chasing. Giroux trying to fight him off. They both go down. I think that's a good no call.
Absolutely. That was good hockey. Well played by Letang.
Now Cook with a one-timer. Saved by Skalov.
Well, all the referees here in the building, of course, didn't like it because Claude Sullivan gambled at the blue line, Steve Sullivan, and Giroux won that gamble. Watch Sullivan, 26, try to steal the puck, and he doesn't. Now, Letang's got to get position. He uses his arm a little bit there, but they're just battling. He gets pretty much even with them there. Yeah, there's some pushing and shoving. You can see that also Giroux is using his free hand at one point, too, to try and get body position. I don't mind that no call at all.
Yeah. Shot through traffic goes wide. It probably helped Letang's cause, too. He kept his feet moving against Giroux as it comes now to Crosby. Wanted to hand it to Malkin. Malkin did a good job just to keep that puck in. Now here's Kunitz. Far side now for Sullivan again. Malkin, one-timer. That changed direction to the corner. Niskanen, the defenseman, had moved up on the play. Under a minute remaining in the Philadelphia penalty. Here is Malkin. Now back to Sullivan for Niskanen. Niskanen tees it up. That's blocked, and the puck is cleared by Couturier.
That got through one layer, but not the next layer.
Now Sullivan for Crosby. Intended for Neal, intercepted. Back the other way. Talbot's got a little bit of room. Now it's closed off by Letang. Talbot goes through him. And the puck goes just wide of Marc-Andre Fleury. Stall back the other way. Knocked away to the line. Dupre, backhand shot. Well, he hoisted it up high, and the force of the shot, it carries all the way back down the ice. Drew thought about going after it, but he was at the end of the shift.
Max Talbot had 100 points when he was playing in junior. Now, that's a while ago, but it just shows he's got the hands. You see him as a penalty killer all the time, but he can make some plays.
Here's Letang with a shot, stopped in front of the puck, is cleared. The crowd all stood up at once, Brian, as the clock hit the 10-minute mark. It's like, okay, our team has gotten halfway through the period, still with the lead. They wanted to acknowledge it. His stall is blocked by Lilia. Shen could not get it through Neal. Shen fell down, but getting some help, Lilia pokes it ahead, and here's Briere. Slides it across now. Voracek with Shen. Pass for Shen, and he couldn't knock it out of midair. Now Shen turns and sends it along the board, but the net behind Marc-Andre Fleury is off. It's been off for quite some time, and I think the officials are so focused on the puck and the play that they didn't see it for a while. But we're down to 9:14 remaining. It remains 4-1 Flyers, but they came close here. immediately following our Game 6 in here in Philadelphia. Bruins and Capitals Game 6 on NBC beginning at 3 Eastern tonight. Kings and Canucks at 8 Eastern on the NBC Sports Network. LA looking to close that out on the road. Rangers and Senators tomorrow at 7 Eastern on NBC Sports Network. Brian and I will be in Chicago for the game on CNBC, which begins at 9 Eastern. The Coyotes and the Blackhawks. The Stanley Cup playoffs on the networks of NBC Universal every game, every night.
Lots of conversations going on, of course. I watched Jaromir Jagr and Giroux before they came out for this faceoff here. Great communication all the time. Jaromir Jagr, very engaged. Giroux, very engaged in this game, they, along with Hartnell. They have tremendous chemistry. They played a lot together during the regular season and have had a dynamic impact in the series and this game.
Certainly been a physical commitment, too, for the Philadelphia Flyers. 33 block shots they have in this game.
Those layers that you talked about in the second period, Dave, absolutely evident there. So tough for Pittsburgh defensemen to get a puck anywhere near from the point all the way to the Flyer net.
Now Hartnell for Jagr. Now Giroux comes over to the corner to help out, but Jagr sends it across. It deflects onto the stick of Hartnell, who sends it back in wide of the Pittsburgh goal. Jordan Staal has it there. Taken away by Jagr. Jagr cuts in, save made by Ford, rebound chance. Was underneath Jagr and picked up now by Letang.
That's one of the things Jagr does really well, steals a lot of pucks.
Pascal Dupuis, up in there with Braden Coburn. Ups up some plays it around, Talbot with some help from Couturier, and Couturier just making sure that he clears the zone. Where's Golub? Canceled off. Kunitz knocks it down. There's Kunitz trying to make something happen here. Crosby in the vicinity. So is Malkin. Now Niskanen shot. Sails up high over the net, being protected there by Brizgalov. And now here is Malkin. A little tic-tac-toe passing attempt. They try to go Kunitz quickly to Crosby. Now high slot. McCulloch sends it wide. Kunitz right back to the front. Brizgalov to save. Gave up a rebound. It's backhanded wide by Malkin. He goes down awkwardly as he and Giroux are battling. Neither team touching the puck. And they're going to call for a faceoff right in the Flyer zone.
Let's go back to Jaromir Jagr on his last shift. Here he is on the forecheck. Gets a stick on it, but then he just stays with it. Good steal there. Real good steal by Staal. Staal probably never expected him to keep staying with it. Staal looking for a play. Really smart by Jagr. He puts a lot of leverage on the stick just below where Staal wanted to make the pass, steals it away from him, and walks out of the corner.
Now Batali and Shen on this faceoff. Ends up along the end boards. Cook, Lilia battle for it. Now Carl plays it around the glass, goes off the glove of Briere, and that's going to be called actually a hand pass against Pittsburgh.
Evgeny Malkin's afternoon, one goal. That was a terrific shot that he made, but for the most part, he's had to fight through just incredibly heavy traffic. Everybody in his face all the time. Couturier, the guy who's been assigned to him most of the time, seems to know exactly what Evgeny Malkin wants to do. He's been able to read him. He's been able to play straight up against him and play just good, solid defense. What a story for a rookie in the National Hockey League. He, along with Matt Reed, that last penalty kill, two rookies out there, which they've done a lot this year. Couturier and Reed doing a terrific job penalty killing as well, too.
Puck is out of play, as we remind you. Tomorrow, 8 more contestants face instant elimination, plus live performances from Adam and CeeLo. Don't miss The Voice live tonight. Event tomorrow at 8, 7 Central on NBC.
And I'd be remiss if I didn't throw Braden Shen into that mix there, too, as a terrific rookie for the Philadelphia Flyers. And on top of that, those three guys have contributed 13 points in the series.
Now, Paul Holmgren, we've talked about this throughout the season, deserves a tremendous amount of credit for the almost complete makeover of this roster with Carter and Richard, two huge players on this team in the past, both going out and kind of retooling the team. And then all the injuries, starting with Chris Pronger, and forcing all these rookies to play a lot more minutes, I'm sure, than the Flyers organization had originally planned.
Well, they had so many injuries. Talk about if you're a good team and you're going to go deep into the playoffs, you have to be able to play more than one way. Yes, you have to have offense, and you have to be able to bring it at the right times and set the tone, which Philadelphia did. But you also have to have that shutdown mode as a team. It can't be just a couple of guys or send out one line or send out one D pair. And these Flyers are showing that they have this plan B as well, too.
Hawkins slid it out to center ice. Coburn dumps it right back into the Penguins zone. Now straight plays it ahead. Kunitz turns. Talbot right on him. Kunitz across the line. Takes it wide. Tried to backhand it to the front. Now back to the line, Niskanen with a shot, and that skips up, and did that hit the netting? Apparently not. Well, have to hit high up on the glass, and it's flipped back the other way into the Penguin zone. Now Niskanen, far side, angles it off the boards, and it's going to be whistled down here with an icing call.
Impressive debuts, certainly, for all the rookies in Philadelphia Flyers, the contributions that they've made offensively, but their knowledge of the game at such a young age, that's what's really impressive, because it's little mistakes that you can make as a rookie that make a difference in a game. I mean, so many one-goal games in most series, not so much in this one. But they certainly have had their close games in this series as well, too. Couturier hasn't made many.
We're going to step away with 5.5 remaining, 4-1 Flyers lead. By Geico, we're winding down the final minutes of Game 6 of this Eastern Conference quarterfinal series between the rival Flyers and Penguins. Philadelphia leading the series 3-2, and they lead this Game 6 4-1. And this is going to be icing here against Pittsburgh.
Pittsburgh's trying some of the stretch pass things that they worked very effectively over the last game or two, but the Flyers, of course, have seen it. Yeah, they got burned a couple of times by it. Jordan Staal scored a goal that was a critical goal in last game because of a stretch play, but you learn by your mistakes, too. The great thing about the playoffs is playing head-to-head against the same team all the time. The coaches do their job. They go over tape, and they come back, and they re-instruct their players. Here's where they hurt us, and here's what we have to change.
Oberg shot is blocked. James Neal back the other way. Wanted to go to Kennedy with a pass. It hit a skate. Here is Kennedy with it. He slides it to the near side of the Flyers zone. But it's hammered by Hartnell all the way back into the Pittsburgh end. Dupre back to get it. Hands it off now for Letang. Far side. Staal with some room. Wrist shot missed on the short side as Brzgalov may have got a piece of that. And Jágr tries to chip it ahead. And second effort, he got it out to center ice. Neal between a couple of Flyers goes down. No call coming. Hartnell pushes it ahead into the Pittsburgh zone. Now Niskanen hands it off far side for Malkin. He doesn't want to just dump it in. He wants to make something happen. And now he knows he has to. Matt Carl on the far side. Plays it up the glass. Glove down by Niskanen, but it was played with a high stick. Brian, as we go back and take a look at the work of Claude Giroux.
And what terrific work it's been. He set the tone in the first couple of seconds of the game. And then shortly thereafter, makes a beautiful move, goes right up under the bar. Playing head-to-head a lot against Sidney Crosby in this series. And then he got an assist for the power play as well, too. That was the ensuing goal. But it was that one-timer that really set it all up. He and his first-line mates, Hartnell and Jágr, especially in the first half of the game, set the tone. Great production.
Well, he kind of set the tone Giroux did at the start of the season. He had 5 goals in the first 6 games of the year, and he just never looked back. It's a terrific season for number 28.
Well, a lot of pressure on him when you think about it, too. Dave, you talked about, you know, the trades of Richards and Carter. And a big part of that was this guy. They knew he had stepped forward when they went to the finals, and he really became a star under pressure. So they weren't afraid of him, but he stepped forward even more this year. And obviously these playoffs aren't over yet for the Flyers.
third in the National Hockey League in points with 93, second in assists. A chance here, Flurry stops Eric Wellwood.
Niskanen just mishandled that coming off the wall. He wanted to pull it off the boards and get it on his forehand. He just plain mishandled it, and that was a free scoring chance out in front. Flurry with a really good save there. Eric Wellwood, watch a puck come around here. Eric Wellwood, there's Niskanen, just can't quite handle it. Inadvertently just pushed it right to Wellwood. Flurry comes up and challenges well and covers up the five hole.
Well, the crowd rising to their feet again here now with 3:55 remaining. Faceoff in the Pittsburgh zone. Giroux, Hartnell, Gustafson, and Briere, the goal scorers here this afternoon. And Briere to Shen. Of course, the Flyers will have a little opportunity to rest. There's always guys that are playing more banged up than you realize. And now heading to the bench is Fleury for the extra attacker, down by three. Miasma pulls the goaltender for the extra attacker. Here is Lilia, able to clear the zone. Braid sends it back in deep. Picked up by the Flyers, and that goes over the glass cleanly, I believe, and out of play. Or
that was deflection. I thought it was a deflection off the Penguin stick. We'll see. Maybe I'm wrong.
Boy, it was close.
I thought Stahl's stick had hit it there, but apparently not. So there is a penalty on the play. Gustafson. The way it was flipping end over end, it looked like it had got deflected along the way. So the goaltender still pulled. 6-on-4 here for Pittsburgh.
Power play number 5. Their only goal came on a power play goal by Malkin, unassisted back in the second period. Now Kunitz. All the way up to the right point, Sullivan. Letang to Kunitz. James Neal with a shot, trying to stuff it down. Whoa, it's in! That puck is across the line. That's a goal for the Pittsburgh Penguins. Ilya Dryzgalov is upset because he felt that it was poked from underneath him.
That was James Neal. Nothing fancy about that from the bad angle. He got it into the paint, and the referees are conferring a little bit here.
Oh, they're saying no goal.
Wow.
After the conversation, now there it is. Covered up, and there's the push right there. You know what? Seeing that, Brian, I think that's a good call. You can't push the puck and the goaltender into the net.
Zone and got it to Talbot.
Away. Set to get it to the front. Bouncing puck. Skips away from a couple of players. Neal's going to chase it down. A minute. In the Flyers penalty for delay of game that's being served there by Gustafson. He comes out of the box. Flyers back at full strength. Angled off the glass and cleared back into the third zone. Stunning because of how after the number of goals scored. And as tight as things are in the National Hockey League, Brian, I think a lot of people, when forced to pick one team, thought that Crosby, Neal, Malkin, and the Penguins, if healthy, would be the favorites to win it all. But they are going out here in the first round.
Yep. Well, they knew it was going to be an incredible matchup, these two teams. And a lot of people thought, Jesus, it's almost a shame that two teams that had such great seasons had to get matched up in the first round. But Pittsburgh, yeah, being healthy again, they'd had a lot of injuries during the season. The Flyers had a lot of injuries during the regular season, too. Overcame a lot of adversity, did the Flyers. And because of that, you can tell how much stronger they are. Offensively, defensively. Questions sometimes about their goaltending, which hasn't been unusual here in Philadelphia over the last couple of years. But Dryzgalov has come through with some key and stellar games when they needed him to in this series as well, too.
So the 08 champion Red Wings are out. The 09 champion Penguins are about to be out. The 2010 champion Blackhawks are on the brink. And the defending champion Bruins are facing elimination coming up next on NBC. There's some new blood. Making some noise here in these Stanley Cup playoffs. As it's Coburn who flips it back. Rolling wide of the open net. No icing. Sullivan got there. Knocked away from Letang by Talbot. Now Talbot again. Surrounded by four white jerseys. The puck is picked up by Kunitz. He tried to play it ahead. Neal got it into the zone. Bouncing puck. Couturier got a stick on it. And it's cleared by Wellwood, who glances at the clock and he sees under 20 seconds now. We'll let the crowd take it the rest of the way. An exclamation point on this game and on this series with the empty net goal.
Well, the structure of Philadelphia defensively made that play. Malkin trying to go one last dash. And Brayden Schenn turns it over, and all he has to do is get the red line and get to that empty net, and he does. Another rookie contribution.
Schenn had a three-point performance in game one of this series. Part of that secondary line with Briere and Simmons. And the final seconds. Kick off the clock. It's all over. The Philadelphia Flyers have eliminated the Pittsburgh Penguins. The Flyers congratulating Ilya Bryzgalov, who didn't have great numbers, neither goaltender did in this series. And there are the coaches who were on top of their respective benches screaming at each other 3 weeks ago in Pittsburgh. But they shake hands here, as is the custom at the end of every playoff series. But Ilya Bryzgalov, who was out in the first round of the playoffs the last 2 years with Phoenix, both at the hands of the Detroit Red Wings, now gets a chance to move on in the playoffs with the Philadelphia Flyers. And these teams that battled so hard and at times fought each other, including Sidney Crosby getting into it with Claude Giroux. And a little extra something there for Braden Coburn, Brian.
Yeah, Dave, this, you know, part of what makes our sport great is the war that these guys went to, especially for those couple of games where things really were out of control. And look at them here, the respect factor. You got to love that.
And that was Max Talbot that just shook the hand of Sidney Crosby. Of course, Talbot, I mentioned, so much history as a member of the Pittsburgh Penguins, winning a championship with them. And not only leaving Pittsburgh, but then signing with the rival Philadelphia Flyers, and then to be a huge part of the Flyers taking Pittsburgh out. And how about Jágr? There was a lot of speculation. Where was he going to play?
Yeah, that's,
you know,
that's
was
a good
he
point.
Was he going to sign with Pittsburgh? Was he going to go to Detroit or L.A.? There were a lot of teams. He ends up going to Philadelphia, and then he, too, plays a huge role in the Flyers defeating Pittsburgh here in the first round. And Max Talbot doing it on both sides of the puck, as he always does. Shorthanded goals, a couple of huge shorthanded goals in the series. And again, the coaches at the end shaking hands. I don't think Claude Giroux has to encourage this crowd to make noise, but he does that. Gets a hug from Ilya Bryzgalov, and here's Claude with Brian.
Claude, the emotion of this series and all the chaos that sometimes went on, it ends up being a close series when Pittsburgh winning the last two games. What was your approach after having lost his last two?
Yeah, we weren't too happy about game four, game five, and coming from our fans in game six, we wanted to outwork them, and I think it was a full team effort tonight.
I have to ask you about that hit on Crosby in the first couple of seconds of the game. Is that just one of those opportunistic things that you see that second and it drives you forward?
Well, usually we never get a good start, and I was just trying to spark the team up, and I was able to kind of get a little hit on him and kind of got the boys going.
The defensive part of your team game just got better and better as this series went on.
Yeah, I mean, it starts with Bryzgalov. I mean, everybody's putting a lot of heat on him, but really, he's one of the best goalies in the league, and he wants to win so bad, and you can see he's working hard, and we're very happy for him that he was solid tonight for us.
Thanks, Claude. Congratulations.
Appreciate it.
Well, I think you can see why Berzgalov gave Giroux a hug. Pretty good words from a leader in that locker room in a series where goaltending was so tough in terms of the numbers. Berzgalov acknowledged there by Giroux for his play here this afternoon. So the final score of Game 6 here in Philadelphia, the Flyers win it 5-1 to win this series 4-2. For Brian Engblom and the rest of our crew here in Philadelphia, I'm Dave Strader reminding you of the Stanley Cup playoffs presented by GEICO. Continue at 3 Eastern with Game 6 between the defending champion Bruins on the brink of elimination and the Washington Capitals. That's coming up after these messages.